Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So are you a blogger that's on WordPress? Are you on WordPress.com or WordPress.org? Yes, there's a difference, and today I am going to explain the difference and I am going to teach you how to switch. Because if you're on WordPress.com, you're going to want to switch to WordPress.org. And stay tuned because the last step is very, very important if you want to keep all of those Google rankings that I know you have worked so hard to get. If you are looking for ways to make multiple streams of income, including monetizing your blog in many different ways, then this is a channel for you. Go ahead and subscribe. And I put out new videos every Wednesday, so make sure you hit that notification bell so you'll be alerted as soon as it comes out. Welcome back to the Freedom Strategy, and if you're new here, I am Heather, and I help you build freedom-based businesses so you can live your life, your dreams, your way. And monetizing your blog is one of the best ways to create multiple streams of income. It is how I was able to ditch my corporate career as a lawyer, and now I help others do the same thing. But it is super important to know the difference between WordPress.com and WordPress.org, and I am here to show you how, especially if you want to monetize your blog. I put up this video just a few days ago on how to monetize your WordPress blog. And in it, I say, make sure you are on WordPress.org and not WordPress.com. And oh my God, the number of people who called me and emailed me and messaged me and commented on the video wanting to know what the heck the difference is, and more importantly, how to switch if they want to switch. So that is why I decided to make this video. Now, I'll be the first to admit, it is really confusing. You've got WordPress.com and WordPress.org. And I want to set the record straight right now. If you want to monetize your blog, the one you want to be on is WordPress.org. Okay, make sure you got that straight. WordPress.org if you want to make money. Now, here's the difference, and this is really just a brief overview of the difference between the two. I asked my husband, who's in IT, like, what the heck is the difference between these two things anyway? It is pretty confusing. He launched it to his IT self and said, oh, well, WordPress is an open source platform. And then one of the founders of WordPress started WordPress.com in order to have a separate thing where he could monetize the WordPress, but the platform itself is actually open source. So if you want more control and more creativity, then Okay, so let me try to break it down for you. WordPress is an open source platform that most bloggers use to do their blogs. It is very understandable why most people say, oh, I want to do a blog, I want WordPress, I go to WordPress.com because that's what everybody knows, and bam, you're in, you're on, it's free, it's a piece of cake. It is what I did, and it is what most people I know who started a blog do. The problem is, it has its limitations. WordPress.com is a free platform, but it is severely limited. And the biggest limitation is that you cannot put your own ads or those with an ad network you might use, like Google AdSense or Mediavine, if you are on WordPress.com. They control what ads get put on it. They even control what plugins you can use. So it is very limited. Now, it's easy, and if you're a hobby blogger and you want to just put out a blog so your family can read it, it's definitely the place to be and you should stay there. But if your goal is to make income off of your blog, which is what I'm here to help you do, you don't want to stay on WordPress.com. WordPress.org is the open source platform that you're going to want to do because you will have much more control. Now, what's important to understand is that while the platform WordPress is free, you will need to have a host to host your blog. That's the difference. WordPress.com is free, but they have all the control. WordPress.org itself is free, but you need a host to host all of the information within your blog. Now, the good news is there are lots of hosts out there. Many, many bloggers start with Bluehost. I'm going to put a link to that below. It's inexpensive. It's about $4 a month. And when you're just starting out, and honestly, up until you have about 20,000 page views per month, it's probably a really, really great solution for you. Again, link to that below. Check it out and see if it's a good fit. But for sure, before you switch over to WordPress.org, you need to have a host set up. So that's why you'll hear WordPress.org is often referred to as self-hosted, because you have to have your own host host your blog. But with that comes enormous flexibility. There are so many more themes that you can use on WordPress.org. There are many, many, many plugins that you can use on WordPress.org that you cannot use on WordPress.com. And again, most importantly, you have the freedom and flexibility to put your own ads through whatever network you choose on WordPress.org. You cannot do that on WordPress.com. And I read an analogy that is, in my opinion, the best way to think of it. And if I could remember who that was that wrote that, I will put a link to it below, because it was a super helpful article on the difference between .com and .org. Anyway, what he said is, think of it as WordPress.com is like having a rental house and WordPress.org is like having your own house. So with the rental, it's great and it's easy and you don't have to worry too much about the maintenance, but you're super limited in what you can do. And with the ownership, it's all up to you what you can do. You have all the flexibility and freedom you want, but it requires a little bit more money and a little bit more maintenance. So that is overall the difference between the two. Most important point being, if you want to monetize your blog, you need to be on WordPress.org. All right, now that you know how important it is to be on WordPress.org, I am going to tell you how you can switch. Yes, you can switch your WordPress.com blog to WordPress.org. So I'm going to tell you how to do it. I'm also going to put a link below to a website that has a very, very detailed step-by-step process that you can follow in case you need additional instruction. Okay. First step, like I mentioned earlier, WordPress.org requires you to have a host. So please go sign up for a host. Again, Bluehost is a great starting point. I put a link to it below. I actually used GoDaddy, which is very similar when I started. And I was great with that for a couple of years until I got up to about probably 30,000 page views per month. Then I had to switch to something bigger and a lot more expensive. But when you're starting or have a relatively small blog, go ahead and start with something like Bluehost. It's really not expensive. It's like $4 a month. Now, if you paid an upcharge on WordPress.com, you likely were able to get your own custom domain that did not have .wordpress in it. If you have done that, you can use the same domain that will transfer over just fine. If you haven't done that, you're going to want to get your own domain. You can again go through Bluehost, you can also go through GoDaddy, but you're going to want your own domain because you don't want your domain to be yourname.wordpress.com. So you need your own domain. Again, that's one of the big reasons of switching. Now, if you've paid the upcharge and have gotten your own domain and use it on WordPress.com, please stay tuned till the end because I'm going to talk to you about you need to redirect it to your new host. You do not want to miss that point. All right, now you have your host and you have your domain. Now, you need to go back to your WordPress.com and export everything that your blog has. This is why it's so much easier to do if you do it early in your blogging career. I've seen people wait 3-4 years to do it, and wow, they have a lot of data to export. But even then it can be done, it just takes a little bit more time. So go to WordPress.com, go into your admin tab, and you will see a link to export. And yes, you want to export it. So hit that button, and it's going to export all of your stuff from your blog into a file on your computer. Just pay attention to where that file goes because you're going to want to find it later. All right, next step, go back to your WordPress.org. You've got your domain and you've got your host. Now you're going to open WordPress in WordPress.org on your new host. Most of the hosts that I have talked about automatically have WordPress downloaded in it. If you've chosen a host that doesn't, all you need to do is download WordPress. It's a piece of cake, no problem. But if you're with Bluehost or GoDaddy, it will already be there. Go to your WordPress.org, same thing. You go to your admin, and instead of hitting export, you hit import. Now, there is a checkbox that's super important on the import box, and that is it asks you if you want to import your attachments. In order to have everything come over exactly the way you had it, please make sure to check that box. You definitely want to check that box. It will make the import take a little bit more time, but you definitely want to do that. Do not skip that. Okay, and that's pretty much it. That is fundamentally how you get your blog from WordPress.com to WordPress.org. Now, there are a couple more things. You can go through your new host and your new WordPress and pick a new theme if you want to do that and make something that's going to fit or actually have a lot more flexibility for you than anything that was available for WordPress.com. And lastly, very, very important, and this is the part I keep saying, wait till the end. Okay, here it is. That is, you need to redirect your blog from landing on WordPress.com over to WordPress.org. This will cost you just a little bit of money, but it's super important to do because you probably are already ranking in Google on some of your pages. You do not want to lose your Google ranking. Go to your WordPress.com, go into admins, and there is a tab to redirect. You're going to redirect it, and then there's a box to fill in to your new URL, and you're going to put that in there. Now, WordPress.com will charge you $13 per year. That's what it is at the time of this video. $13 per year to redirect. Well worth it. You should definitely do it. And I would say do it for about 2 years, because after about 2 years, then Google kind of gets it. You're over here. Everybody knows where to find you. But I do think that process is worth doing for about 2 years. $26, honestly, best money you've ever spent on your blog. Okay, I know that is a lot of information. Again, I've got a link below to take you to a website that has it in detail, exactly how to go through it. Please follow that link. But honestly, once you get in and start doing it, it really is not that difficult. The sooner you do it, the better. So now that you know, yes, you want to switch to WordPress.org, and yes, the number one reason of doing that is because you want to monetize your blog, I have a free ebook for you. The link to that is also in the description box below. It is a free ebook and it tells you all about how to monetize your blog, including ads, including sponsored posts, and it will get you well on your way to making real money with your blog. And if this video has helped you, number one, understand the difference between WordPress.org and .com and helped you understand how to start the process of switching it over, please give it a like and also please subscribe. And if you're ready to think outside the box and buck the traditional system and start creating multiple streams of income, and your blog is just a great way to do that, then go ahead and type hashtag bucket in the comments below, because that is what it's all about. Again, my name is Heather, and I am happy to be with you here on your journey to financial freedom. I will see you next time on The Freedom Strategy.